Oh my god! No! Wait, my phone was in the mashed potatoes!
And then the battery exploded.
Hey guys, it's my fam here, and today we're gonna be doing a mukbang. I don't even know what you guys call it, a mukbang. But we went to Popeyes, and this is my first time ever eating. Oh, she's just going in. This is my first time ever eating Popeyes, and I heard their biscuits are dry as hell, but that's fine. So we both got some mild chicken wings with some mashed potatoes and gravy. So I'm gonna try this biscuit.
Where's the butter? I don't think I got the butter.
These biscuits are pretty dry, but it's good. I'm used to going to KFC. I told you guys to ask me questions on my main account. Go follow my Instagram if you guys haven't already. And yep, let's just start reading questions. What's it like living together? What's it like living together, Han?
It's only been 2 weeks.
Yeah, we've only lived together for 2 weeks, but like,
we haven't killed each other yet, so that's a good sign.
Yeah. I'll insert actually text messages right here about us arguing, and then just next thing you know, it's, do you want to go to the pool? Like, I feel like that's what every sister does, but we argue, but we don't fight. Like, we haven't screamed at each other yet. I'm saying yet, because like, I feel like it could happen. But yeah, we haven't screamed at each other. How is it like living in the new apartment? Problems and good things. Okay, problems was our door didn't lock for 2 weeks, and it like barely even shut, so we could have gotten kidnapped. Another problem is she dropped her keys down the elevator shaft.
That was more of my fault.
Yeah. There's police and ambulance going by like every night. So,
and there's this dummy who decides at 12 o'clock at night, he comes home and he locks his car 8 times. Like, just to make sure it's locked, like, beep, 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 beep. 8 times.
Yeah. And like, when I first moved in, like, it was just me. The guy that was helping me move in was like,
that's like a relatively quiet neighborhood.
And I was like, why'd you lie to me? Good things. Oh, bad things. Oh, there's no AC. I
wanna die. I'm sweaty all the time.
Uh-huh.
There are a lot of reasons why I'm single. My sweat's one of them.
Me too. Wow. In my last vlog, you guys see that I was literally just like sweating the whole time profusely. And then, like, in my Instagram caption, I was like, good thing the shitty Instagram quality can blur out this sweat. Good things. Our rent is like only like $1,100. What else? It's like actually located in like a good area, because like she can drive to work like really easily. And it's like the LRT station is like right next to our apartment, so I can get places really fast. Does your sister live? Okay, someone just asked if my sister lives at the apartment. Yeah, she lives with me. Or I live with her. We both live together. What was your worst argument? We haven't really.
You locked the door and I didn't have keys. Yeah.
That wasn't an argument though. It was just more like a 2 second phone call. That
you being a dumbass.
Yeah, so as I was saying, our door doesn't lock. Wow. And so our door finally got fixed. So I locked the door because I forgot that she didn't have keys. I locked the door and I go all the way to the south side, you know, having myself a good time, and then I get a phone call from her. She's really screaming at me. She's screaming at me over the phone. She's like, did you fucking lock the door? And I was like, yeah. She's like, why the fuck would you do that? And I was like, I forgot. And a phone call ends and she texts me. She's like, send me your location right now, I'm coming. So she comes and it takes her like 25 minutes. It's like a far ass way. It's like all the way across the city. And like, she pulls up, she calls me and she's like, where are you? And I'm like, I'm in front of this place. And then she pulls up, rolls down the window. I give her the key and she just rolls it back up and leaves. You don't say one word. And this is like yesterday, by the way. What annoys you about your sibling? Okay, what annoys you about me?
That you're actually cooler than I am.
She's 6 years older than me and she's like doing nothing.
Age doesn't mean you get cooler.
You have...
I think you actually get lamer.
I have a better life experience than she does at the age of 15. So...
Oh, hell no. I had lots of good life experiences. I did a lot growing up.
Okay, whatever. Okay, what annoys me about Hian is she cares too much. She cares way too much. And, like, she's so indecisive. That's the thing that annoys me the most. Like, I do something like, I don't care. She's like, oh, should I? I don't know. What should I get? She like always needs advice and she always needs like opinions and it makes me so mad. She can't choose anything on her own.
That happened like 5 minutes ago.
Exactly, like it happens all the time. It happens like every day. She sends me selfies and she's like, which one should I pick? Which one do you like? And I'm like, I don't care, Ian. She's like, yeah, but like, I'm not good with picking things out for my face.
I'm not good at picking anything out. Especially with looks. That's my worst thing. I'm just, I don't know what looks good on me. I don't.
No, I never ask people for advice because I know that if I know what I like and I know what I don't like.
But that's the thing. It's not like me wondering what's gonna, people are gonna like. It's me not knowing what looks best on me because I don't have an opinion. I really don't. It all looks the same to me.
Like same trash.
With like, same with my hair and stuff. It's like, I don't, my hair color is red because my best friend thinks it looks best on me. So I'm like, yeah, sure.
Well,
whatever.
How do you guys like Edmonton so far? So I lived back in Wycourt. I lived back in Wycourt and she's been living here for a bit now because she lived with our cousin, but she lived in Camrose. So we basically both moved here, but she's been living here longer and I like it a lot, like a lot. I like the people in Wycourt like 10 times better, like 100 times better. But like the town itself is so shitty. There's like nothing to do. But like, as you guys saw, I've been posting a lot more because there's a lot more to do here. And how do you like it?
It's good. It's hard to drive everywhere. It's really annoying being far away from your friends and whatnot. And it's harder to do things after work in the city. It's harder to, you know, always go from home from work, get ready to go to the gym, go cook dinner. It's really hard to get adjusted to that, but I'm doing okay.
See, because like, I feel like I'm a lot more motivated here because back in Wycourt, I was living at my friend's house and like there, I would just like lay in bed all day because I'm like, oh, I don't really want to like go upstairs and like get up and shower and then have to come back to my room because like, I don't know, when I was at my friend's house, I didn't really like feel comfortable just like sitting in the living room, but like here, I can just like, do whatever I want.
We're naked in the living room 24/7.
Huh?
So you're naked in the living room 24/7.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, what? I can just wear no clothes and like, also here, like, I actually like have my own food and stuff so I can like cook it. Instead, like back in my crib, I felt like I had to just like go to McDonald's and get a $5 meal deal all the time, you know?
Yeah, I'm doing that now.
Okay, love life update. You guys always ask about like how the boy, like what happened to the boy that like wrote her that note.
They don't talk anymore. Ghosted him.
Yeah, because he asked to go on a long walk in the rain. Like, who wants to do that? It was nighttime too. Like, she's not trying to get kidnapped. I feel like if the guy was like really hot and it was like a romantic movie, that would be cute. But it's just, yeah. It's in like a sketchy neighborhood. Like, we live in the hood, you know. Her love life update. I don't know. She's always talking to me about guys, and I never say anything because like I just don't care and like I just don't
single. Relate. But I guess it doesn't matter because everyone watching this is like 15.
Everyone asks me about like boy advice and like how to deal with like F boys and stuff. Oh, first thing, I don't. And second thing, I haven't dated anyone since like grade 6. So shout out to you, Cruz Wheeler. I love you.
I'd be the one to ask about F boys.
Because I just don't like deal with them. I just, I don't know.
You're also 15. I hope you wouldn't deal with them.
Okay, there's more F-boys my age than there would be your age. People your age would be more looking for like an actual relationship with a man. Okay? Okay, like, I don't know. No, but the thing is, like, Ian, okay, guys, you guys don't know, but Ian likes to talk to the skids that play like ball and like go fishing. Okay, not like, okay, not going fishing isn't like doing skid things, but like, she likes to talk to boys who don't have a job and don't have anything better to do.
She talked
to boys without jobs who like to just like play ball their whole life because they don't have a job to be going to.
One time.
So don't ask both of us, don't ask any of us for life, I mean for love life, because she'll do tell you like, you know, like go for the boys that don't have a job and like don't have a life together.
I will tell you to go for someone who actually puts in the effort, because it can't always be one way. And no matter how much you think that you can change a guy, you won't.
I just get bored very easily, so I just ignore
people. Oh, me too.
I ignore people so much. Like, I'm sorry to all the boys that get mad when I don't reply. Don't worry, you're not the only one.
Yeah. Like, the thing, here's the thing, though. Like, guys always get the bad rap for being the player and stuff. But honestly, if a guy starts like ghosting a girl or starts being annoying, like she's got a list of like first round draft picks that she can choose from. Like, she's got so no problems. Honey's got no problems.
It's so true though. I feel so bad for guys in a situation that they actually have to like work to get a girl.
Oh yeah, effort is key to my young men out there.
I doubt there is any young men watching, but yep, okay.
Yeah, okay.
Favorite lashes. Or do you recommend any good ones? Oh my god, I keep burping. Okay, so I just ordered a bunch off of AliExpress. Search up Mink 3D Lashes. Those are really good. But right now, I'm wearing ones that I stole from my sister. They're called the Velour Lashes.
No wonder her lashes look so freaking bomb.
They're good. Let's see. Where do you want to live when you graduate? And someone asked, would I ever move to LA? Well,
take my spoon?
I'm not... Wait, I thought you had two.
Yeah, where is the spoon?
I don't know. Anyways, what do I want to do when I graduate? Honestly, no idea. Since like grade 8, I was kind of just like, yeah, I'm gonna go and do like environmental science and stuff like that because like I really like this stuff. But like now I'm just kind of like, yeah, I didn't realize that's what she did. But like now I'm just kind of like, I don't know. But
then it's okay not to know, and you won't know until you fall into that profession or whatever.
Definitely, I think something in like media or like something in entertainment, that'd be really cool. Or just like, I see this YouTuber, she's like doing, her job is basically being a social media like entrepreneur where she like, she shows people how to like grow their social media and stuff like that. Like that's cool. Yeah, she just did environmental sciences and then she turned into accounting and now she wants to be a teacher and shit like that. She doesn't know what she's doing with her life. Don't listen to her.
No one does. That's the thing. You go into something thinking that's what you want to do and it just doesn't happen. Or it is what you want to do, but you just don't follow that path. And it's okay not to know. And it's okay to be unsure about yourself.
Anyways, someone asked, who's messier? I say we're both equal.
Equal, it depends on the day. Her bathroom's pretty messy, but then she tidies it up.
No, I definitely feel like I have more motivation to make my room clean. She has like no motivation to do anything.
I have no furniture. I have no nothing. I have no motivation to do anything.
Like, I have the thing is like my cleaning my room videos, yeah, it's messy, but like I kind of just like, it's not like it gets that messy right away. It's more like I clean it, like I just get it, like I don't know, I just don't clean it on a day-to-day basis. That's why it gets so messy. Mm-hmm. But like it's also, I'm doing that like on purpose so that like I could film a cleaning my room video, but I don't purposely make it a mess, you know what I mean? But I also like clean my room every day, like tidy it up, same thing with my bathroom. So yeah,
and I don't make it a priority to clean unless I have the time just sitting in front of me kind of thing. I like to put my time into other things, like being lazy.
And trying to find a boyfriend.
Yeah, playing a lot of ball. Usually those go hand in hand, but ball boys suck.
Someone said, how come y'all got no furniture? Because, okay, so
does anyone have a truck?
I haven't filmed, hit me up if you guys live in Edmonton, you guys have a truck. I haven't filmed a cleaning my, I haven't filmed a moving vlog number 3 yet.
Is he cute?
Who? Look. I don't know. The sunlight was in his face. Okay, so I haven't cleaned up moving out vlog number 3 in a while yet. It's because we don't have any furniture and it's because we don't have a truck to move any furniture. So, yeah.
Just two broke girls without a truck.
Yep. How much is the rent and does my help pay the bills? The rent is $1,100. Do I help pay the bills? No, I refuse to.
So, she doesn't pay
all the bills.
In some kind of video, and I got a couple angry messages.
It was in my live stream, actually.
In my inbox about...
I'll insert them, okay?
Okay, wait, here.
And, like, she texted me, and she's like, what the hell is this? They don't even correlate. And, like, she was just so pissed off that people were DMing her. But, like, it's because I put on my live stream that, like, I don't have my...
How do people find me?
Like, I was telling everyone, I was like, go DM my sister and tell her to stop making me try to pay $500 rent, because I don't want to do that.
Okay.
Oh. So we're back. I just changed for ball. This is my first time ever playing ball, so I hope I'm not bad and I don't embarrass myself.
Are you live?
Okay, no. This is my first time like playing it. Like, you know, like school is way different. But I brushed my hair out because it was looking a freaking mess and it's so dry.
You assured me that you're not gonna get a bone.
So dry. But
why is there chicken?
She just sat on a piece of chicken. Okay, anyways, continuing. So that's that. We still got our Popeye. Well, I still
freaking
got my Popeyes.
Dave just texted me.
Hey,
I said, what's up? He says,
did 3:15. Next goal is 4:05 on squat.
Like I care.
He's just trying to flex, guys. Okay. Anyways, we're gonna continue answering your guys' questions because you guys are just so interested into us.
I don't know why.
Okay. Does your sister have an Instagram or YouTube account? She does not have a YouTube account. She's talented enough.
I made a YouTube account just to troll her YouTube account.
Yeah. She made a YouTube account just so she could comment and like try to like be funny. But like the thing it is like, nobody cares.
It was like 2 a.m. I was not trying to do university
stuff. She was just jealous of my YouTube. So I just like, oh, maybe I should finally watch her videos.
It was mostly comments like, that's my shirt. that's my sweater. Hey, is that my makeup?
Wow, but funny. Yeah. How tall are you? It should be, how short are you? I'm 5'2" and she's 5'3". And everyone thought, when we were younger, everyone thought that I would grow way taller than he and.
Oh, yeah. 100%. Everyone's like,
because he was just like a little chubby 5'3" person. I was like skinny and my legs are long.
Yeah. I have like a body of a dancer. I'm like, I have the body of like an athlete. So I'm like short and stubby. Wide shoulders, short legs. I'm a wrestler. She had a body of a dancer.
I don't dance. No. I play like volleyball, basketball, and all that stuff. But yeah, everyone thought that I was gonna be the taller one. But I'm not.
Everyone all kept right. telling me to drink my milk.
Okay, yeah, when we were younger, we were told to drink our milk, and I just like hate milk because I was forced to drink milk every day. Like, I was forced. Like, there was a certain time to be like, Kate, you have to drink your cup of milk. And then we would just like kind of, me and my brother would just like sip on it and be like, we don't want this anymore. And
we'd put it in the fridge.
We'd put it back in the fridge, and then we just would forget about it.
And I apologize if you guys saw me viciously eat my chicken not too long ago. I was very hungry and forgot that you could see my face.
We keep getting asked questions about what we find annoying about each other, about that one guy.
This means I need to go back on the prowl so you guys can ask about different guys.
Yeah, and oh my god, all of you guys were talking about Langley in my vlog. Like, no, that was like my third time hanging out with that guy.
You don't kiss on the first date. Or the third.
Hang out with a chicken. I don't wanna like drip this all over. Okay, I need to find another question before I eat this piece of chicken. Forgot this was a mukbang and not just a question and answer. You should get a dog or cat or even a fish for your new apartment. Okay, we're not allowed pets.
And first of all, fish smell. But you think a fish should be like the best pet, right? You don't gotta walk it, you don't gotta really feed it, it just kinda lives in its own little aquarium. It stinks. They stink. We got one in university for our dorm room, which is a room with two beds in it. It stunk up the entire place.
Ew. This is so oily. Oh my god! Ew, did you see this?
Wait, don't say oh my god when I'm driving. I'm like, where's the incident?
I need me some napkins. Oh my god, that is disgusting. I feel like that's my sweat I'm wiping off my nose. That was gross.
We are so early.
Sorry. How many days of school are you gonna go to this year? Fun fact, my sister and my brother were really worried about me and they didn't think that I would graduate because that's how much I miss school, guys. Like, I think I talk about this in every video, but like, you guys always ask for like school advice and stuff on my live streams, and I'm like, stop asking me because like, I don't even go to school myself. Yeah,
No. I actually was nominated for person who attends school the least. I was that person who would show up to midterms and finals and they'd be like, you're still in this class? But it's the way we learn, the three of us. We are motivated by stress, so we're really good at cramming and actually retaining that information and stuff, I've noticed.
Yeah. I don't go to school, I just like kind of learned it on my own, and like, yeah, I don't write notes
ourselves.
Or anything. Like, actually,
I write notes.
Huh? I don't really write notes that much. I mean, like, I kind of like, in class, I can just listen, or I can just like scribble a bunch of shiz on my page, and then after I have to go back on my own time. I will never do this in class. On my own time, I will actually rewrite my notes down way nicer, so like it doesn't make me mad. I actually feel like reading them over again.
People learn differently, and different things motivate people, and like how we learn is very subjective. And in high school, the thing is, they don't realize that the teachers are there to want to make you pay attention and like engage you. But when it comes to university, you're on your own. That's when you learn how you learn the best. I learn the best by learning myself and then teaching. I teach my peers, and that's how I learn.
Yeah, like when I went to Toronto or whatever, I had a research project that was worth 15% of my grade, and I didn't start it or anything, and it was like due in a week, and everyone was already like done their research and everything, and like she made us hand in this thing where it was like, hand in what you have done, and nothing done. I got like, I think like a zero or something on that, and then I went back in, I told her that like, I just finished it on the, like after I got back from Toronto, I told her that I finished it all on the plane and stuff like that, and she gave me 100, because literally on the 3-hour plane ride to Toronto, I finished the whole thing, because I was just like, okay, I wanna get this all done before I do anything in Toronto.
So. I wrote, I had a 12-page paper due one day on like the economy of like India or something, and I started it the morning of, and I got 16 pages done, and I got like a 95.
I did mine in like 3 hours. Mine was like on the globalization economy. I got like an 83 or something, and like that's really good for doing it in 3 hours. Like, everyone was like, what the hell?
If you guys have questions about school or post-secondary, I'd be the person to ask about that.
Oh, finally insert her Instagram. But, like, I mean, I guess you guys can if you guys want. But if you guys actually have questions about high school and stuff like that, ask her. Don't ask me, because I actually don't know. Because, I live in a small town, so, like, I wouldn't know anything. Because, like, school is also a lot different since, like, you know everyone since, like, you're in grade one. So, like, you don't have any problems with friends and stuff like that. Especially, like, me, I never had problems with friends. So, like, I don't know that, so.
But also, I tutor a lot of people from kindergarten to high school and stuff, and I understand the struggles and different how people learn and making friends and stuff. I get it.
Yeah, so ask her if you guys want anything. Let's see, next question. The Bachelor or The Bachelorette? Okay, if you guys don't know what that is, me and Ian used to watch it so much when we were
religious.
Yeah, we used to watch it so much. But like, after she went to university and stuff, obviously we don't anymore. But like, I like The Bachelor more because like girls are like
crazy.
They're crazy and like they just so much drama. But for guys, it's just like, yeah, like I can lift more than you and stuff like that. Like
I'm a gym junkie. It's whatever.
But like with girls, it's like so much drama, so much crying.
It's so much better. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. It's kind of funny to watch like the guy try to stay sane while dating like 25 other women. It's hilarious. When your love life sucks, watching a man try to date 25 different women is just super entertaining.
Where did your dog go? Like, he was so cute, but he's never in your videos anymore. So my dog died.
Which one?
I'm kidding. Diesel, my dog, so my brother has his own apartment and with his girlfriend, so they just kept the dog because my brother's girlfriend stays at home.
I think I took the wrong turn. Oh, shit.
Because my brother's girlfriend stays at home all day, so it's better if they have the dog because, like, I would say I'm always at school, but I was just, like, always doing something. So he took the dog, and now they have two Pomeranians, and it's just a great life there, you know?
I have no idea where I'm going. People behind me know that I don't know where I'm going. Okay. Oh, now we're crossing the water. We weren't... What the... Look at this!
Oh, my...
Look what I gotta do.
Look what she did.
I don't know what I'm...
Oh, my God.
Okay.
Whatever.
The city of Edmonton, something I hate, the driving, the confusing roads.
Cody Noble asks, do you play any sports? I play, a lot of you always ask if I'm gonna play volleyball, and it is if I'm gonna make the team here. I didn't vlog any volleyball last season because honestly, last season was the shittiest season I've ever had in my life. Not like playing wise, but just like, I like vlogging when like I like the people around me and like it's just fun because like everyone else wants to be in the vlog and it's just very entertaining. But like, just last year just was not a good season, so I didn't vlog it. But I play volleyball. I'm not gonna play basketball this year because I hate running so much. Like, maybe I'll consider trying out, but like I hate running so much. And also, like, I'd be playing for a city team, so I would probably not get played because I'm kind of bad. So yeah, I play badminton. Badminton is a sport that like I never took seriously, and I just decided to play it this year so I could go to tournaments and have fun. But like, I ended up making it to provincials out of my whole school for like the first time in like 6 years. So like, I think it's just a typical Asian thing. And then I play, what else do I do? Oh, track and field whenever like it's actually happening, like long jump and triple jump, because I can't run with my small legs. What sports do you play?
Growing up, I was never good at one thing. I'm more of a jack of all trades, and same. I would feel like you're a little more specialized with, say, volleyball.
Yeah, I know, but stuff. I still can play everything though. Yeah. But like,
no, but like for me, like I was never good at just one thing.
Wrestling. She was like a provincial player.
National, but it was because I only joined because two guys told me I couldn't do it. But yeah, so like wrestling, volleyball. I tried basketball. I play a lot of slow pitch now, like golf. Snowboarding.
I'm so bad at golf, guys.
It's so much fun.
Who is the hotter sister?
Oh, it's this direction!
Okay, if you were just...
I think it's very subjective. Where am I going? Okay. It's subjective.
It's me.
Because it depends on your style, because our styles are very, very different. I don't know.
It's me.
No, because people who find you attractive don't find me attractive, but people who find me attractive wouldn't find you attractive. We're very different.
Yeah, but the people that also find her attractive are the skits. I'm happy about that.
Time.
And I'm happy one time. Yeah, okay, whatever.
Whatever, meter loser.
Most most embarrassing childhood memories of each other. Okay, fun fact. So when she was like, I think like probably 14 or no, probably like 15, she had friends over, and me and my brother like always were like those annoying siblings that just like always wanted to play with her friends. So like one day she like locked her door, and she was in there with her friends, and like we literally took knives and we stuck them under the door and just in and out, and just like they threatening her.
Called the cops.
Oh my god! 14. My phone was mashed potatoes.
And then the battery exploded.
Oh my god, that's bad. Okay. Anyways, yeah, we called the cops once, and it was my brother.
Yeah, that was the same time. Not once. It was the same night.
Oh, okay, yeah. And then, okay, no, what I remember was we printed out this picture of, like, the cops, and then we printed, like, we wrote down on it, like, missing or something like that. Just, like, I don't know. We were dumb. And then my brother and his friend, Lane, Lane was the one that ran me over, by the way. My brother and his friend, Lane, they called the cops because, like, I don't know, they just thought it'd be funny. And then the cops actually showed up, and it was literally me, my sister, her friend, and then the two guys, and, yeah, they showed up. And Lane and Wang went up to my parents' closet and hid in the walk-in closet because they were so scared.
Okay.
All right, guys. So that's it for the vlog. I hope you vlog. That's it for the mukbang. I hope you guys enjoyed.
If you say mukbang,
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 mukbang, muk, muk,
mukbang.
That's it for the mukbang. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. Go follow my sister down in the description box below or right here on the screen. Social medias are right up there. Until next time, peace.